Hi, good evening, everybody, and welcome to your episode 372, Turning Point Devo for Monday, your fantastic Monday, October 17th, 2022. Our beginning passage today is 1 Corinthians 1:9. Our recommended reading is Hebrews 10:19-25. Our turning point is from Philip Keller, and the Bible reading is Mark 10-11, and today's title is called Promises. And that a fellow colleague at church, who my brother and him were closer than they grew up together, but he is now the church's music pastor. But at one time he was involved with three other guys in what they call River Jordan, and he's been away from the group for so many years now, so the group is still doing appearances and stuff. Well, when he was with them, they did a song, and the song was called Promises. And I can't remember the whole gist of the chorus. But it's like Promises, do 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 and do 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 do. Promises, do 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 do. All the things he's done. That's basically all I can remember. But Jim and the other guys from River Jordan, I just wanted to give you a shout out because that song reminded me of that song, and I like that song. It's a pretty good song, so hope you reach out to me about that song. That'd be a good one to Jim. That would be a good one to get the group of guys up to do it at Grace. I'd love that song, and I would love to be in on this, on that project. So let me know. Let me know next time you see me at church. So. But if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Smashing the like button will help the video reach other people as well. Comment. How was your day today? How'd your first day of the new week go? And what are you looking forward to in the coming days of this new week? But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me get to the 20 subscriber mark by Halloween. And then when we get there, if we can get there, that's just 2 more subscribers. All I need to hit 20. And if you do that for me, I greatly appreciate you. Because if I hit the 20 mark, then we go to 30 by the first of the year. That'll be the next step to go to. So, but without further ado, let's hear about promises. 1 Corinthians 1:9. God is faithful, by whom ye were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. So when we look back over our lives, excuse me, some of our greatest regrets involve moments when we broke a promise to someone. Ooh. In some cases, we made promises that we simply were not able to keep. Yeah. On other cases, we found it was convenient to make the promise in the moment, but we hadn't really thought through the implications. Yeah. Been there. I'm gonna lie about that. I've been there. I've been in every situation about that. Sometimes we just shrugged off our unreliability as par for the course. Yeah. But sometimes we've haunted by our fickleness and failure, especially if we disappointed someone. I don't think I've ever done it that far is to disappoint someone because of breaking a promise. I don't think I ever done it that bad that I can recall. If I have, and you're watching, the person's watching this video, I'm sorry. Just going to get it out there. I'm sorry for hurting you. That I don't recall doing it. So as we grow in Christ, we understand the sanctity of promises, for the Bible is full of them. And we rely on each one. We also become more Christ-like, growing to be faithful as He is faithful. And before we go any further, let's turn in our Bibles to Hebrews chapter 10, verses 19 to 25. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Didn't mean to get that on camera. Chapter 10, 19 to 25. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way which He consecrated for us through the veil that is His flesh, and having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for He who promised is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together as in the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Okay. So many people today in today's world are undependable. They don't honor their word. That's right. Whether it involves their workplace, relationships, or marriage, let's do better than that. And let's remember that God is faithful, and we can count on every word in His book. Amen. So W. Philip Keller says, I know of nothing which so stimulates my faith in my Heavenly Father as to look back and reflect on His faithfulness to me in every crisis and every chilling circumstance of life. It's going to be a little bit longer one to try to put that in the tags. I know of nothing Heavenly Father look back and reflect His faithfulness to me every crisis and every chilling circumstance of life. I think I put the ones I'll put in that when I do that one. But I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe. And all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Have a great rest of your fantastic Monday evening. Come back tomorrow for another terrific Tuesday. And more to learn from God, including episode 876, part 1, and number 118 of the Thus series, with the sinner's prayer with Luke 18:13 from Henry M. Morse, and 876 part 2 Beyond Words from Mark Dehaan, derived from 2 Corinthians 12:1-10. And in tomorrow night's Turning Point, episode 373, we're going to be drawing near. 2 Thessalonians 3:3 is our beginning passage. Psalm 73:25-28 is the recommended reading. Meister Eckhart with the Turning Point. And the Bible reading is Mark 12:13. So, stay tuned for those. I'll get to those later tonight, but you'll see those tomorrow at 7, 1, and 7. 7 a.m., 1 p.m., and 7 p.m. So with that said, I love you. God bless everyone, and I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great rest of your evening, everybody, and I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.